Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your most excellent, right, reverend brother from another mother, coming to you on-demand video via YouTube. And I forgot what FEMA region I'm in. I always have, whenever I'm going to decide I'm going to say the FEMA region I'm from, I keep forgetting. I had to look it up, what FEMA region I'm in. But anyway, I mean, I forgot now. I'm down here in North Carolina. Whatever FEMA region I'm in, I'm sure that the government knows which FEMA region I'm in. They can tell me. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I just wanted to make this quick video because they keep asking me to do it, and I keep forgetting to do it. Because when I usually make a video, I'm just like thinking about what I'm going to say or the topic. I don't usually think of what I'm going to say, but I think of the topic, and I have these ideas of the about the topic that I want to get across. How, who, when, where, why, and how I'll say it, or if I'll say it, is a mystery. Led by the Holy Spirit. Anyway, brothers and sisters, we're having a fellowship. Sister Linda Kirby, who does the What's Going On newsletter, which you can subscribe to. She gets all the scoops. She has got the Lord has given her all these divine connections with, you know, with insiders and all that kind of stuff about JDM and all these things, you know. And she's in the loop. She's in the know, you know, to hear from whistleblowers and all this kind of stuff. So anyhow, we're having a fellowship dinner, really from what she's been doing. The Lord's led her to do these fellowship dinners, and then she's gonna answer questions about the rapture, pre-tribulation rapture, and then I will be preaching. I'll be there. We'll be fellowshipping with the people there too, and talking to people. And then I just found out there's going to be a pastor who's visiting from the Philippines. And so I'm going to talk to him and see, you know, if it's a divine appointment from the Lord, if we can do something there where he's from in his area, the Philippines, when I go there in December. So the fellowship dinner and slash revival, and I'm praying for a mighty move of God. I ask you all to pray for a mighty move of God. That's going to be October the 10th in Charlotte, North Carolina. But the for the dinner, there's a RSVP because they're, you know, they have to know how many people at the church has to know how many people they're going to prepare for. So the RSVP is by October the 5th. So this is already like the almost the end of the month, like the end of this week or whatever. So I'm going to have Linda Kirby's email address below here. I ask you to please contact Linda Kirby and get RSVP'd so you can get signed up, and then they'll know how many people are coming. You know, it's just because it's not just preaching people to show up, which is great with me. But in this case, because of the dinner, you know, and the they're trying to cook and all that, help them coordinate, you know. And this is, I ask you guys who are coming to please do that in the love of Christ, so that the people who are doing the food will be, you know, have a good count. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I also wanted to talk. While I'm making this video, I should talk about my travel plans. As the Lord leads me, as you know, we already scheduled this thing October the 10th. We were going to do it in September. And I was going to have in Texas, and then I was going to invite several other people to come who do YouTube videos, but they were all not wanting to come because they were convinced that the rapture, all the other people I invited would not come in September because they thought the rapture was going to happen in September for sure, guaranteed, and didn't want to be there. So we went ahead and scheduled one October the 10th. In North Carolina, and my philosophy has always been this, you know, because I've even had people, I don't know why people are so short-sighted, and I don't know what it is, but, you know, people say, why are you making orphanages if the rapture is going to be this year? The rapture, and I've even had people tell me, oh, the rapture is going to be this week, brother. There's no need of you doing an orphanage. There's no need of you doing the feedings and all that. I mean, come on, that is not from the Lord. We keep going until the Lord comes. And Jesus even talked about that in Matthew 25. You know, blessed is the master when he comes, his, you know, he finds his servants working. And so I'm going to be about my Father's business until he comes, till the roll is called up yonder. I'll be there until the trumpet sounds and the Lord, you know, the dead in Christ rise. And then we'll go up at that moment of the rapture, whether it be today or 10 years from today, by the grace of God, by God's grace, and with his help. I will still be serving him on that day by his grace and with his help. My desire is to serve him. You know, and we can't ever say what we're going to do because, I mean, you know, anybody can, you know, can fall away. I mean, we could decide that we're tired of serving the Lord and we want to go do our own will. And that people do it every day. There's people that walk away from the ministry and from the Lord all the day. I can't remember every day. I can't forget now. There's some statistics you can look up on the Google and see that whatever it's, how many hundreds or thousands of, you know, pastors quit every year. Not just pastors, but Christians who walk away from serving the Lord and just become a backslider. You know, and then eventually some of them totally fall away. Next thing you know, they're claiming they're an atheist. You know, it happens. And so for all those once saved, always saved people. You know, I thought about making one of a 30-second video on that the other day, and I didn't do it. So let me mention it now. For people who believe in once saved, always saved, have you ever thought about this? That once saved, always saved people also believe in free will. You know, they're not, and I explain that because lots of people don't know. You should know, but lots of Christians don't know, that, you know, your Presbyterians and those guys are what they call Calvinists. They believe in what people will call it predestination, but it's, you know, what they're teaching is the total sovereignty of God. In other words, you don't really have a free will. That's why you see free will Baptists and all these different denominations, because like John Wesley, the Methodist, they believe that you have a free will. You know, John Wesley's the other person. There was a handful of people in the Great Awakening in the United States. One was John Wesley, the Methodist, and then another guy, George Whitefield, who was a Congregationalist. George Whitefield was a Calvinist, and he believed in, you know, predestination. And John Wesley believed in free will, but they were still friends. And John Wesley even preached George Whitefield's funeral, even though they had this theological, you know, they even debated about it and stuff. They were still brothers in Christ. And God used them both to be part of the Great Awakening in the United States about the time of the American Revolution, and back in those days, 1700s. But the point is if we have a free will, so in other words, it's this. I should make a quick statement here, a succinct statement. If once saved, always saved was true, then free will cannot be true. You know, because if we have free will, we can walk away from the Lord. So in other words, people believe in free will until you get saved, and then you lose your free will. If you believe that once saved, always saved. You have free will, and then you lose your free will when you get saved. You are now a slave, and you can't stop being a servant or a slave to Jesus Christ, a bondservant of Christ. You have no will, no free will anymore. But the opposite appears to be true to me. People still have a free will. There's lots of people who are walking in the Lord and serving the Lord, and then, you know, they backslide. They go off the deep end and quit the ministry, and there's people they go through all kinds of whatever kind of situation you could think of. As a matter of fact, there's one famous singer. His name is, of course, I never listened to him. I don't listen to anybody with a mullet. But this guy, old Bolton or whatever his name was. It was they love to have that old cheesy, goofy music on Christian television all the time that's not really worshiping the Lord, but some kind of old goofy, cheesy music. Anyway, one of those guys with a mullet there, a poodle mullet, he turned out he was gay. I don't know if he turned gay or was gay, whatever. His name's Bolton or something, his last name. A few years back, man, it's 2007, 2008. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm just rambling on here. But anyhow, by the grace of God, we will be traveling be on October 10th in Charlotte. And then I have some commitments I made to some of my relatives here, basically, I guess, through the end of the month of October. And then in the first week in November, I will be in Florida. I will be in Florida, and I don't know where all in Florida. I know for sure I'll be going to Orlando for at least 4 or 5 days. I'll be seeing some people there, doing some baptisms in Orlando. And then I may go other places in Florida. I'm not sure on that yet. Then I will be going to Dallas in November. Probably will not be there on November 22nd because it's probably crowded at that time. So I need to go earlier in November. I may go straight from Florida to Texas, to Dallas. And then we will be going around December 1st or sometime in that first week of December. I'll be going to Seattle, Vancouver, maybe Portland if I hear enough from the people there. Before, I had lots of people that wanted to meet me in Portland, but it's been a year or two since I was going to come up there, so I don't know. You know, that'll be in the beginning. So my goal is, unless I hear different from the Lord, is by December 15th to fly from Seattle to the Philippines because I don't want to be traveling too close to Christmas. It's already close. get there to the Philippines before Christmas because my wife is going to be, excuse me, is getting, will be getting further along in her condition. And we're going to, by the grace of God, it looks like we'll go ahead because we have no family here. We don't have a support network here, really, because my family's, as I mentioned before, was not really Christian and stuff. So I've got brothers anyway. I don't have any sisters. And anyhow, so I'll be going to the Philippines through the time that we have the baby. Then I'll be back here in April. So the Lord has wanted me, told me to go there and do some crusades anyway, because there's lots of people saying, about the rapture. And of course, my word doesn't supersede the word of God. But the Lord had talked to me actually November. The Lord told me to go to the Philippines in November, a few months ago. So I guess I got to tighten up my schedule to try to get there. But I'm running up against a wall because of the amount of time my wife can spend out of the country for her citizenship. So, like I say, that's why if I hear different from the Lord, I'll tighten up the schedule and I'll pray about it again. But unless I hear different from the Lord again, clearly to make sure it's from the Lord, a confirmation, I'll be in Seattle and Vancouver the first week or two of December, then heading out approximately December 15th or so to the Philippines for 4 months. And by the grace of God, I'll be doing lots of crusades there, evangelism. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I think that's all I was going to say in this video. God bless you guys. Please RSVP with Sister Linda Kirby for Charlotte, October the 10th. We're also planning, and then in Dallas, like I said, I'll be seeing you guys there. And we're also praying about doing more of these events if the Lord leads us to. And I asked you guys to pray about that. I would like to do more ministry work in churches. I know they haven't been open to me too much because of the preaching that I do. The church has fallen so far away that they put you outside the church. Like John Wesley, he had to go outside the church and stand on the gravestone of his parents and preach salvation by grace through faith there in England, in front of the Anglican church where he was a Church of England preacher. And they wouldn't let him preach the gospel. So he went out in the yard, and that's what started with the open air brush arbors, these open air evangelism. John Wesley really was used by God to pioneer that in the modern age, in the age of the end of the dark age, into these last days. Anyway, God bless you guys. God bless.